Welcome to a lesson that will explain why dividing by a fraction is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal. Normally, when given a quotient involving a fraction, we write the quotient as a product. For example, 1/4 divided by 3/8 is equal to 1/4 times 8/3. Dividing by 3/8 is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal of 3/8, which is 8/3. But the question is, why is this true? To show why this is true, we will first write the given quotient, 1/4 divided by 3/8, as a complex fraction as we see here. Remember, a fraction bar means division, so these two are equal. And now from here, we will create an equivalent complex fraction by multiplying the numerator and denominator so that the denominator of 3/8 is equal to 1. Remember, we create equivalent fractions by multiplying or dividing the numerator and denominator of a fraction by the same value. Looking at these two examples, 6/15 is equivalent to 2/5. 6/15 is also equivalent to 12/30. So now going back to the complex fraction, if we want the denominator of 3/8 to be equal to 1, we would have to multiply the numerator and denominator of the complex fraction by the reciprocal of 3/8, which is 8/3. So for the next step, we multiply 1/4 by 8/3, and we multiply 3/8 by 8/3. And now we simplify. Looking at the denominator first, 3/8 times 8/3 is equal to 1, because the product of reciprocals is equal to 1. Or if we don't recognize this, we would first simplify out all the common factors between the numerators and denominators before multiplying. Notice there's 1, 3, and 3 here and here, 1, 8, and 8 here and here, giving us a product of 1. And now in the numerator, we have 1/4 times 8/3, and because the denominator of the complex fraction is now equal to 1, we can drop the denominator because dividing by 1 is not going to change this product. This simplifies to 1/4 times 8/3, and now we've shown that 1/4 divided by 3/8 is equal to 1/4 times 8/3, or dividing by a fraction is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal. Before we prove this is true for any valid fractions as shown here, let's determine this product, which is also equal to the quotient. Again, before multiplying, we would simplify out any common factors between the numerators and denominators. Notice 4 and 8 share a common factor of 4. There's 1, 4, and 4, and 2, 4s, and 8. Multiplying, we have a product of 2/3, which also gives us the original quotient. Now let's go through this process one more time for the quotient of any two valid fractions. Let's begin with the quotient of a over b divided by c over d and show this is equivalent to a over b times d over c. Again, the first step is to write the quotient as a complex fraction. The next step is to create an equivalent complex fraction where the denominator of c over d is equal to 1, which means we multiply both the numerator and denominator of the complex fraction by the reciprocal of c over d, which is d over c. So we multiply a over b times d over c, and c over d times d over c. And now we simplify. Again, in the denominator of the complex fraction, we have the product of reciprocals, which is equal to 1. Or showing the work, there's 1c and c here and here, and 1d and d here and here. Verifying the product is 1. In the numerator, we have a over b times d over c. Because we have a denominator here of 1, we can drop the denominator, or dividing by 1 is not going to change the product. This is equal to a over b times d over c. And once again, we've shown for any valid fractions, a over b divided by c over d is equal to a over b times d over c. Again, dividing by a fraction is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal. I hope you found this helpful.